right after the wedding. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We're gathered here, wonderful occasion, celebrate the wonderful sacrament of the Holy Eucharist, the wonderful sacrament of the sacrament of matrimony. We're here to pray and to celebrate with Jimmy and Mel and their families as they take this big step in the great leap of faith. So we begin all things asking ourselves the times that we failed our Lord. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind those sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. I don't know if the opening prayer is in here or not. If it isn't, okay. Hi, guys. It's right here. Oh, there we go. Let us pray. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for James and Melissa. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Blessed the husband of a good wife. Twice lengthened are his days. A worthy wife brings joy to her husband. Peaceful and full is his life. A good wife is a generous gift, bestowed upon him who fears the Lord. Be he rich or poor, his heart is content, and a smile is ever on his face. A gracious wife delights her husband. Her thoughtfulness puts flesh on his bones. A gift from the Lord is her governed speech, and her firm virtue is of surpassing worth. Choicest of blessings is a modest wife, priceless her chaste soul. A holy and decent woman adds grace upon grace. Indeed, no price is worthy of her temperate soul. Like the sun rising in the Lord's heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. The word of the Lord.
See, taste and see the Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us all praise God's name. I called the Lord who answered me. From all my troubles I was set free. Worship the Lord, all you people. You'll want for nothing if you ask. Taste and see that the Lord is good. In God we need put all our trust.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all. How will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, was raised, who is also at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No. In all these things, we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you." The Gospel of the Lord.
I think one of my servers is trying to play a trick on me. Just wanted to make sure he was awake. Thank you, Eric. Very honored to have here with me, I'm Father Rocha from the diocese here at Kansas City St. Joseph, formerly the vocation director and now the president of our new high school, St. Michael the Archangel. Very honored also to have our concelebrants here with us, Father Gerard Alba from the Archdiocese of Kansas City in Kansas, and then Father Jim Meisenberg from the Diocese of Lincoln, friends of the family, and very happy to have you here with me. It was really a wonderful opportunity to witness a beautiful relationship coming together with Christ at the very center. I remember a few years back when I had just recently was assigned to live at Christ the King Parish, I was always celebrating the 6:30 a.m. daily mass. I don't know why Father Lockwood always chose the noon, but he gave me the 6:30 a.m. daily. But I loved that because I loved starting my day early. But I was witnessing quite a few young adults coming to Mass. It wasn't ever very good with names. I coached football for 14 years, and that's why the players always had tape on their helmets, not only on the front but also on the back, so I can recognize their names. And try to learn them. But so I always had a hard time with names. Now, with the young ladies, I never had a hard time remembering their name. I already put that to her, and probably because of the beauty of all the ladies, maybe that helped me remember their name. But for the men, I always had a problem. What's your name? Jimmy, he said. Okay, great. The next time I saw him at Mass, hey, Bobby. No, Jimmy. Next time at Mass, hey, Tommy. No, Jimmy, Father. And I said, next time at Mass, hey, Timmy. He said, no, Father, Jimmy. I go, how am I going to remember your name? And then way back, I remember taking my high school football coach, who was like a father to me, to KU Med, and he had a time in between appointments. So he said, well, let's go grab something. And it was late afternoon, so we pulled into this place, and it was called Jimmy's Jigger. And I said, now I can remember your name, Jimmy. And so every time he'd come out then, I'd say, Jimmy's Jigger. And that's how I remembered Jimmy's name. So we go all the way back to just over 2 years ago, wonderful Solemnity of Mary, Solemnity of the Assumption of our Blessed Mother. What a great Marian feast day. It was just over the 2 years ago that Mel and Jimmy went out on their first date. It was a wonderful opportunity. They came to Mass that morning. I believe I may have called him Timmy or Tommy at the time. I didn't quite know his first name, but I definitely knew Mel. And it was a wonderful opportunity and a wonderful time for them to grow into love together. And it was, I believe, after the announcement of their engagement, we wanted to celebrate. So where did we go?
Jimmy's Jigger. Fine establishment, just off near KU Med. But it was a wonderful opportunity. They wanted to see it. I wanted to go back there for a second time. But it was awesome to see how this love, their love for each other, just continued to grow, and how Christ was always in the center of that. That's one of the most basic words that you hear used each and every day, the word love. Now, it's a simple word, but it can also be a confusing one. How do we reach love's deepest meaning? We hear today, always in the readings of St. Paul, where he talks about putting on love. He talks about love being that bond of perfection. And we know that that ultimate meaning of love was given to us when our Lord Jesus, the Son of God, died on the cross for all of humanity. The greatest symbol of love is our Lord on a cross, a crucifix, a total self-giving by Christ. So love is not just words, it's also action. Love means that we give ourselves away to another person, even if it means making sacrifices for the other. The world tells us, and the devil tempts us, to live for ourselves, but our Lord Jesus shows us that life must be lived for others. So the crucifix is the greatest symbol of that sacrificial love. And today, Mel and Jimmy, when they unite themselves in bond of that sacrament of marriage, when they profess their vows to each other, they won't just be joining hands. In the middle of their hands will be a crucifix that I also give them as a gift for their wedding. But they keep that, and that crucifix, that God must be in the center of their lives together. Our Lord says in today's gospel, this is my commandment: love one another as I have loved you. There's no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. This is what the sacrament of marriage is all about. Mel and Jimmy, after today, God calls you to live no longer for yourself, but for each other. You're called to be one and to give witness to that binding force of God's love. You're to love each other the same way that Christ loves his church. A lot of people say that this kind of love is impossible. And yes, it is. It's humanly impossible. That's why we're here today in this church. You see, what God unites today is not only just you, Jimmy, and you, Mel. That's not enough. No, God unites his very self to the two of you. And this marriage is not just between the two, it's between the three. We continue by God's grace that you can say with confidence that you'll love each other in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, all the days of your life. And yes, these vows will be challenging at times. You'll need to be reminded of them. Jimmy, remember those four simple words: whatever you say, dear. Okay. And the great opportunity you'll have to renew these vows is right here at Holy Mass. That Last Supper, we know our Lord says to us, take this, all of you, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. The blood of the new and eternal covenant poured out for you and for many. Mel and Jimmy, that's exactly what God calls the two of you to do each day. You must say to each other, take this. Take my body, my very self. Take it, it's yours. And so the best opportunity, again, to renew your marriage vows is here at Holy Mass. And each and every time you attend Mass together, to pray and to think about that amazing gift of love, of self-love that God has given to you. You renew your covenant with each other as Christ renews his covenant with you. But I would be remiss if I didn't remind you to also go to Mary, as you will today after receiving Holy Communion. Entrust in her love for you
as her children, and her intercession to only draw you two both closer to her Son. She is the mother of all mothers. She is the world's first love, as we see in Archbishop Sheen's comments you have on your sheet. She truly is a wonderful mother for us to ask for her intercession. In addition to that love that God promises us, also never forget the love of all these people here. They've come from near and far to celebrate with you two today. What a great honor and privilege it is for me to witness this marriage covenant that you'll make today. Mel and Jim, I pray that God richly blesses your union, that you become an inspiration of a deep and compassionate and merciful love amidst a world that is so much longing for hope. God bless you. At this moment, I invite Mel and Jimmy to come before the altar and also with their wedding party to exchange their vows. My dear friends, you've come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister in this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, James and Melissa, I ask you to state your intentions. James and Melissa, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I have.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I will.
James and Melissa, since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you now to join your hands and also this crucifix and to declare your consent before God and his church. I, James, take you, Melissa. To be my wife. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. Okay, Mel. I, Melissa, take you, James.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. James and Melissa, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, men must not divide. Amen. Melissa, you go first to kiss the... Great. We can have the best man and the maid of honor. The blessing of the rings and then the exchange of rings. Heavenly Father, bless these rings in which we bless in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, so Jimmy goes first. You get the small ring, right? Okay.
Melissa, take this ring.
Melissa, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. James, take this ring.
James, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Great.
Awesome. Ask everyone to please stand as we now take this opportunity to offer our intercessions up to our Heavenly Father, thanking Him for this wonderful time, this wonderful union, these united James and Melissa.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the repose of the souls of all Watson, Rapicki, O'Keefe, and Quinn family members, Tom Watson, Rita and Al Rapicki, Rita Rapicki, Rose and Don Quinn, Gary Quinn, Johnny Vap Major, and Jim O'Keefe, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the guests who have traveled from near and far to celebrate with Jimmy and Mel, that the Lord will bless and protect their journeys home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all missionaries, especially those who serve with the Fellowship of Catholic University Students and St. Paul's Outreach, that God will bless them as they spread the joy of the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For City on a Hill Young Adult Ministry, Heart of Redeemer Community, and Catholic Challenge Sports, that all participants would have a desire to grow deeper in their Catholic faith and cultivate authentic community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all couples who model the beautiful sacrament of matrimony, that these couples may share in the joy of today and be reminded of the grace received on their wedding day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that they may stand true to the core values of faith, hope, and love, while understanding the importance of carrying on Christ's love through the family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we give you praise and thanksgiving for the many blessings bestowed upon us, especially the blessings of the sacrament of marriage, of the nearly 150 years of these families joining together. May Mel and Jimmy continue that wonderful streak of love for each other. May they unite them, their very selves to you, to your Son Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. We prepare for the liturgy of the Eucharist. You guys kneel. Okay. Yeah, book and
The chalice.
Yeah.
Perfect.
of the earth and this we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life.
Water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, and the self to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, with your goodness, divine work of human hands, become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity. Cleanse me of my sin. Wipe my nakedness with a swig of water during the Holy Holy.
And pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you. And with your spirit, lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony, an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore,
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these, his servants, now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of one heart in love, by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, and that they might no longer be two, but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church, O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, Melissa, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, James, entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. There's going to be three of Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
The reception of Holy Communion is reserved to those of the Catholic faith in good standing with the Church. If you're not of the Catholic faith and would like to come up and receive a blessing, please do so by crossing your arms across your chest.
The body of Christ.